Mabuhay! Great day, guys! Welcome to TSA Toy Stash in action with another toy review, and I'm Ranger Dave, and today we're gonna check out the Masters of the Universe Origins Zodac figure. So I'm totally excited about this figure. Zodac is one of the most interesting characters, especially because he's essentially like a guardian. You know, he keeps the balance between good and evil, so he's like an anti-hero thing. You know, you sometimes see him on the good side, sometimes on the bad side. You know, it's really messed up. But yeah, that's basically him. But let's go ahead and check out the figure itself. So let's get it out of the box. And here he is, guys, outside the packaging, Zodac himself with that beefy goodness. So this is actually a really stiffed up figure, guys. He actually looks way bigger and taller than the other, you know, Masters of the Universe Origin figures. And yeah, as you can see, guys, completely awesome detail. It resembles that vintage you know, feel, which is basically what the Origin figures are aiming for. So as you can see, this is the head. The detail on the head, this looks very much as the vintage, going here towards the body. You know, you get the likeness of the entire figure. Yeah, and so really cool detail. This actually looks like Merman's hands though, for us, you know, for a second. Yeah, especially if I look at it clearly. Yeah, kasi dito sa parang fins, and also the bad guys. Now I've seen this on Skeletor and also for Merman. Yeah, sa boot, I think this is reused you know, bodies or molds. But tsaka maganda yung build niya talaga if you look at it here. So I love it. Alright, now going for Zodac's accessories. He really doesn't come that much. So you got a blaster. Yeah, so this is the iconic blaster that he has. And that's it. You know, you won't get anything else but this blaster. So pretty decent detail. Yeah, and you got the comic book. And this is the Wave 3 comic book. So if you haven't seen it, yeah, so this is the back. Front, got Skeletor. This is 2000X version. I like it. And so if you open it, you kind of see here the first page. I just want to read it, you know, just post it. Yeah, so Ganesha, really cool. And so you get all of these pages, and then that's the mini book, you know, that's the mini comic book that you get. So that's all. Okay, you won't get anything else. All right and applying the accessory for Zodac, guys, this is the gun. Yeah, so this is self-explanatory. You just take the gun and then you just stuck it in here. And so I'm not gonna, you know, go through that so much because madali lang naman siya. You could do it on your own. And so that's really neat. And I like how it looks on his hands, really dope. And and also you could take, I always want to try this. It's really not that if you want to take it, but I got Roboto's hand right there, and then you get the blaster. I was actually, you know, trying to check if this thing grabs in, and yo, okay, it's not gonna work. So yeah, that's it. Pretty useless gun. Now let's get to the juiciest part of these figures, which is the articulation. Now the articulation is pretty dope. Alright, so all you need to do is just grab his head on a ball joint. Yeah, so you can spin 360 up and down. You can tilt it a little. Yeah, and go on dun sa ano niya dito sa articulation. So again, you can spin it, yeah, up, down, then tilt it a little. Yeah, I guess you can raise his hands about that high, and down, and then you could turn it around like that. Yeah, so again, that's gonna happen. Go on and it's a scope, pasan tatanggal, you know, you could take it off. It does wobble here at the waist. Yeah, and so really good articulation right there. You could raise up his entire leg about that much, and then back that much, single jointed right here for the knees, boot cut, and then, you know, right here for the ankles, that's a hinge and ankle pivot. Yeah, I almost forgot, it does have a single jointed elbow right there. It does swivel over here, a hinge as well, you know, and it does swivel here at the wrist as well. Okay, now going for the size comparison, which is Roboto and Man-at-Arms here at, you know, as I said, it completes the look, guys, you know, especially the colors. Although I really like to point out that there is improvements within the knees. You know, they've been like customizing everywhere here at the knees to get it up, you know, get it upwards further. So if you actually look at it here, guys, Zodac does stand way taller than, you know, Man-at-Arms. This is because I've seen it, I've checked it already. They did something here within the knee. They made him taller, and it seems that he does have a bulkier body. Yes, I don't know, I do feel that that's a Beastman's body, but if you look at it, you know, with the regular Man-at-Arms, it is, you know, he is way bigger, and he's actually taller if you check it out, you know, right here at the head. Yeah, and so that's it. And if you actually look at Roboto's knees, it is the tallest, you know, standing guy. All right, so that is just an improvement. So I wish they could make all of these origin figures the way Roboto stands right now. All right, guys, so that's my take for the Masters of the Universe Origins Zodac figures. In the paint and the sculpt are completely, you know, reminiscing for the vintage line. Dad's actually, you know, one of the big MOTU fans, so we had to get it. And yeah, I'm actually happy about it. You know, he's actually a pretty dope character. I like him, especially on the 2000X version. This is actually way, way too close. And yeah, I'm gonna give this figure a 5 out of 5 rating. And so I wish they could have added more, you know, weapons like the staff on 2000X. But remember, guys, if you are new to the channel, please do hit that subscribe button and hit that notification bell to be updated on every new video we have here on the channel. That wraps it up, guys. Remember, life is one big collection. Peace out. God bless.